I must say that I'm really impressed by the amount of sophistication you all put in your JSXcraft construction which we saw in the last 3 days, and I have to apologize before my workshop that my examples are very raw and very not very polished. Okay, so today I want to pick up where we ended on Tuesday, namely arrowheads. And it's always amazing how much time one can spend in creating arrowheads. And but I will use it as giving you a view in our lab where we create JSXcraft, so to say. The latest arrowheads we created with MetaPost. And what's MetaPost? You probably know Bézier curves, which are a very beautiful tool to create banded lines. So you have two points, A and D in this case, which are the starting point and the end point of a curve. And for the Bézier curve, you need two further control points, which define then, and these four points define the shape of this curve. And it's always difficult to control the control points to get the desired shape. And this was also known to Donald Knuth when he invented MetaPost, the system to create the fonts for Tech. And so he defined a spline type which computes the two control points by itself. And this meta font was then transferred to MetaPost to make graphics. And you can see this dashed line is a typically MetaPost spline. So you define points where this path has to go through, and you define restrictions on these on the slopes and so on. And this MetaPost line is now implemented in JSXcraft. And we have set up I've set up a small tool where I can define the arrowheads. So I can do something with this and make it a little bit more bent. And then maybe also this one. And then I can read off the resulting Bézier curves. And then this is transferred into the SVG code and the canvas code. Okay, this is what we have. And now maybe I pick up you, or probably I will pick up your suggestions to also make this type 7, which we had on Tuesday, make it a little bit nicer. And then we will have type 8 and type 9 and so on. Okay, these are the arrowheads. Just a quick look on some new features we had since 1.0 last year, or at the beginning of 2021. Angles now have an adaptive radius, so it's also some sort of responsive design. If you look at this angle here, angle alpha, it's now exactly one unit. The radius is one unit. And if I change the size of the board, the angle relatively increases or decreases. It adapts in certain bounds. So if one uses angle equal to a radius equal to out equal to auto, which is the default now, then it increases in certain bounds. Okay, then the next feature I during the one of the webinars in spring, I reminded you to the or the participants to the quite old method set angle. So you can set a fixed angle. And like here we have an angle and now it's not fixed. We have three defining points and an angle here. And the radius is 3, it's fixed now at the moment. The radius is fixed. So, and we can call set angle. And board update has to follow in this case to make it active immediately. And here it is. And now you can drag all points and the angle will always keep at P3rd it's very flexible now. It doesn't look very impressive, but it was quite intriguing. It's a quite complicated construction. Okay, then what's also not very well known is that JSScraft JSScraft supports math checks since quite a few years. So the LaTeX in using LaTeX in labels and texts, and meanwhile KTeX is supported too. It was not documented in the API yet, but now it is. And here's an example. Of course, you have to include the KTeX libraries. And then, you have to declare somehow that the text should use KTeX. So use KTeX equals true. And then you can use it, for example, in a text like this here. Or you can use it in a slider. And in a slider, may consist of three parts, namely a suffix and a unit label. And here the suffix is T1 and the unit label is also a chase KTeX. Or it's LaTeX text. Yeah, okay. So the documentation will come with the next version. And then Bernard also mentioned it in his talk. We have some new math functions since the beginning of the year. Then first some really math functions, namely the error functions and the related things, and the arcus cosinus hyperbolicus in German and the arcus sinus hyperbolicus are available now. And we have all the Boolean operators like lower than, lower equal, greater than, greater or equal, equal, not equal, not, and then the Boolean operators like not, and, or, and additionally XOR. We have it as methods available in jxg.math. This solves the problem if your Moodle or some learning management system filter really throws out these lower than or greater than or equal or the end, then this is the last resort where you can get help, and you have to use these methods in your code. Yeah, and a last improvement in the
May I interrupt you? There are two questions in the chat concerning the performance of KTech and math checks.
Marty, you're right. It's suffix. I have to check if I have all the prefix. I have to look at the documentation. I don't know. I don't remember. And math checks in KTech. I'm not a real expert. I would say in terms of speed, if you're using math checks version 3 and KTech, they are more or less comparable. And as far as I know, but I may be wrong, KTech specializes on math formulas. So I don't have to add here the dollar signs or something like that. It assumes that what you put into late in KTech is a math input. And in contrast, math checks, it tries to, the ultimate goal is to translate a full LaTeX document into HTML. So it's much more, it does much more math checks. I don't know if KTech works in Moodle. I have no idea. Okay. What I wanted to say about last year's new features are, this was a suggestion from one of the users. So you can have Jesse code in a script tag, and then it's automatically interpreted. And now you can have a source attribute. And load additional files. Okay, and now I want to show you some upcoming JSX Club features which will be in the next new version, which will be at the end of October, will be published in the end of October. And the first one is, it was suggested by Martin when we were riding in a car recently together, and he wanted to have, he uses the Lagrange polynomial, and he wanted to have the term, the function term of the Lagrange polynomial, and here it is. So you can supply points create a polynomial or a curve through these points. So if you have 3 points, then it will be a polynomial of degree 2. And we want to have the formula, the term of this formula of this polynomial, and here it is. And you have to call, at the moment, Lagrange polynomial string. We may change this a little bit. It may be a sub-object of Lagrange polynomial. I don't know yet. And up to now, we have these parameters, namely the points. then the number of digits which are displayed, the name of the parameter, the variable, and the symbol for the multiplication. You may also discard this or use math checks or KTIC or whatever. Yeah. Okay, good. And then this is the first one. The next one is a new JSX graph element. It's called foreign object. Why do we need this, or what is it? So JSX graph elements are positioned in 20 layers above each other. So you can, for each element, you can choose in which layer it will appear. Okay. And you probably know the JSX graph element text. And for text, you can choose the attribute display, and you can choose between HTML and internal. What does this mean? If you choose HTML, it's a division, an HTML division, and you can put arbitrary HTML code into this division. But this division lives above the SVG or the canvas, which is used by JSX graph. Okay, it lives above in terms of layers or set index, if you know CSS. In contrast, you can use display internal, and then it uses the SVG element or the canvas element text. And then you can put it in an arbitrary layer, but it only supports what the SVG element text supports, which is barely nothing, just the text. Okay. So either you can arbitrary, up to now, you can either position arbitrary HTML code above the construction or simple text inside of the construction. For images, we have also the SVG element image, which can be put in an arbitrary layer in between. Okay. However, in SVG, we have the element foreign object, which allows to put arbitrary HTML into an arbitrary layer. And this is now accessible in JSX graph. Let's start with an example. Here's a simple example. This is a string in a div in layer 8. And this blue point is in layer 9. So it's above. And the red one is in layer 7. And so it's below the div. Okay. How does the code look like? So it looks like this. We have a new, or it will look like this. We have a new object for an object. And here you supply arbitrary HTML code and supply the position of the lower left corner and probably a layer and fixed equals false. Okay, and how is the size determined? It seems to have a certain size. Well, it's determined by the div itself. So the div has a special dimension, size, width, height, and this is used. So it has a class block, and block is width 150 pixel and height 30 pixel. Okay, yeah. So actually this is the same as the text element, but you have to supply it your own diff and can put it anywhere. So, and yeah, next example. You can put a video inside of the you can put a video inside of the foreign object. I will also show it directly here in code. Well, it's a video tag. Yeah, and it's in layer zero, so it's at the bottom, so to say. Yeah, and I will start the video. And now I can put the curve above the video, the Lagrange polynomial above the video, and get the curve. Okay, and well, and I can also make it a little bit more invisible, like opacity equals something like this. Then maybe better, you can do it for demonstrations. Okay, the diff or the foreign object is formatted like images. So you also have the lower left corner defined, and then we have the dimensions, the size of the rectangle given as a parameter array 12 and 8. So it's 12. Units wide and 8 units high. It doesn't look like 8 units, but this is because the video keeps its original aspect ratio. Yeah, and but for this I have to supply width 100% and height, and width and height equals to 100%. Okay. So you can choose whatever you want. Yeah, and the next thing is this one. So you can also, I don't know if it's useful or yeah, it might be useful for some things. you can put an iframe, for example, an iframe into this foreign object, and this iframe could also contain another JSX graph construction. It could also be a division containing a JSX graph construction, but here you don't have access nearly to the content of this JSX graph construction. It's completely blocked. There's nearly no access. Okay. Yeah, and this is also, you can drag this above, but it's who gets the event is a little bit involved at the moment. At the moment, this has, both boards fight for the mouse pointer. Yeah, okay, this is what's coming up. I hope you find it useful. And then some things about the so-called JSX graph ecosystem. we submitted an H5P content type to the H5P homepage. Which is H5P? It's a popular Moodle extensions, mainly for schools. It seems to be very attractive. And we have set up a a new GitHub project, H5P. And it's very, at the moment, it's very simple. You can supply some text before the construction. Then you can supply the construction like this. And then you can supply something after the construction. And yeah, we hope that it's accepted. At least meanwhile, people have started translation of this. There's a translation system, and maybe you can volunteer and you translate it at their translation project. Okay, and then finally, we are building, or we have built, a new place to share constructions. We had this discussion on yesterday. This is at least the first step. So we hope this this will replace our wiki in the future. So we're building a database with a lot of examples. At the moment, they are not very well. We have just a few tests in the example, and you can immediately create your a fiddle or show a QR code and a link and copy the construction for using it in Moodle and so on. And this will be built up, and we are still discussing how we can how we will do the user handling, because we don't want to have the a full anonymous user handling in our database. We will see. And but Andreas will show you a video right now.
Welcome. We are Raphael and Andreas from the JSX Graph development team in Bayreuth.
Today we'd like to introduce you to our JSX Graph database. There you will find a lot of examples and tricks around JSX Graph.
Let's start on the homepage. Behind this website is a large database that contains all examples and data. Here you can see that there are currently 48 examples and 49 tags in the database. Of course, this will be even more in the coming period. We are in the process of collecting and populating examples from various sources. Here you can see a few selected interesting constructions in a slider, which you can also try out right now. We refer a few important tags that you should definitely take a look at too.
Let's see how to navigate the database website. On the left side, you can find the navigation sidebar. The first entry navigates to a page with all examples from A to Z. The database isn't static, it keeps getting bigger and bigger. The light blue entries after all examples are navigating to pages where you can see tags and associated examples. You can find tags with mathematical or technical content. Each of the main tags you can see here have several subtags, like for example geometry. You can find associated subtags by clicking on the small arrow right next to the main tag. But they are also listed on the tag page. Let's have a closer look to the tag page of geometry. Here you can find an alphabetical list of every example having this tag or any of its subtags. You can exclude or include examples from subtags in this list by toggling the switch in the upper right corner. At the end of every tag page, you can find the tree of subtags. For example, by clicking on basic constructions, we get to the tag page of basic constructions. Here you will find again all associated examples, and you can see that the sidebar and the breadcrumbs are helping you to know where you are in the tree of tags.
So you can find an example via its category, its tag, but if you're looking for a specific keyword, you can also use the search. Just enter your term here and click on search. With just one click, you can go to an example and take a look at it. An example always contains at least a title, one tag, a board, and the associated code. Most of the time, there are also a few descriptive words up here. With the code, you can understand and recreate the example, but more on that later. This example has another specific feature. It has a dark blue badge up here. That means it belongs to a group. If we click on the badge, we come to this group. A group is a collection of several examples. For example, this can be a step-by-step guide for programming. Or, as you can see here, there are presented several attributes of a circle.
Back to the example view. Here's a slightly larger example. As you have already heard, every example must have at least a title, one tag, and JavaScript code. But there is some more information which you can find on an example page. Some examples have more than one board, like sine and cosine. Right below web references, you can find links to some interesting web pages. You can also find referring examples after having also a look at, like sine. Sometimes there are buttons or text areas which are connected to the boards.
If you want to see nothing but the code and its implementation, there is the raw view. For example, this site can be shared with others. In addition to the raw view, of course, there are other options for what you can do with the constructions. You can, for example, simply print them on paper or convert them to a PDF with a PDF creator. Or you can copy the link to the raw view of the construction into your computer's cache. Of course, the link is also available as QR code. This also leads to the raw view. Maybe it's interesting to see what you can do with the code. Of course, you can copy the JavaScript part. We have built a button for this purpose, with which these lines of code are added at the beginning. This makes it easier for you to adapt the example to your own environment by simply entering the ID of your divs. If you want to copy the div at the same time, you can also use HTML and JavaScript export button. Here the code is in a script tag. The formatting in Moodle is once again special. The JavaScript tag is used. The copied code can easily be integrated into a content area in Moodle. It may also be useful to download the construction as an HTML file, but be careful. JSX graph will still be loaded from the server in this file, so either an internet connection has to be available or the library has to be installed locally on the PC. At last, and perhaps most interesting export function is JSFiddle. If you just click on this button, you can easily continue working on the constructions or change parameters. This makes it easy to try out other ideas.
So those were the functions of our JSX Graph Examples database. We hope you will use our website regularly and pick up ideas there.
Of course, we are also happy to include your worth-seeing examples. Just write us an email. Thank you very much for your attention.
Okay, thanks. I hope you will like it, and we will have much more possibility to exchange ideas. Okay. Yeah, and so we will gradually fill this database now with the example, and maybe hopefully refactor the examples to be in the latest JSX graph coding style. Yeah, and then it will be available in January probably. Okay, then this was the end of my small workshop.